Hey, what's going on there, guys? You've officially arrived at the 420 scene, and today we're gonna talk about my best and favorite Fox Farm soil recipe. But first, show some love and support by watching the entire video, dropping a like, subscribing, and tapping the post notification bell so you don't miss out on any future videos. And also, check out our sponsors, Robert Bergman's ILGM and Mars Hydro, for all your horticultural needs. Also, be sure to join our VIP Patreon program for tips, monthly giveaways, live streams, all that good stuff. Link will be in the description below. And also, don't forget, if you wanna come and sesh with us, check out our grows, and you know, you just wanna chill with us, follow us on Instagram. Link to that will also be in the description below. So today I want to talk about my best and favorite Fox Farm soil recipe, and I'm just going to say it right here, right now. If you just straight up don't like Fox Farm soil for, I mean, any reason at all, oh well, it is what it is. This video is mostly for beginners that are just trying to start with a simple recipe just to get going, and the idea here is to get you guys growing so you get a pretty decent harvest without having to know too much off the bat. I know when I first started out, I really wish I had this video to actually follow. So now I'm passing it out to you guys. And before we get any further, I want to give a huge shout out to CLTV. They're like really awesome. They've actually been shouting me out. We might be going live with them sometime in the near future. So if you guys haven't checked out CLTV, check them out. They got a cool podcast every Sunday. I think it's every Sunday. All right, so first off, I want to talk to you guys about my experience with Fox Farm soil. And I watched a video a very long time ago. Maybe it was back in 2013 or 2014. And I watched Cali Green. I was just starting out, so I had absolutely no idea what soil I should use or even why I should use it. But the one thing I remember he told me was that your soil will make you or break you. Which is absolutely true. And back in 2014, Fox Farm Ocean Forest wasn't hot the way it is today. I have been using Ocean Forest on the last run, and it's really not that bad. I also mixed it with some Happy Frog. We'll get into that a little bit later on though. Now, I know a lot of you guys have been complaining about how hot Ocean Forest is. I know some people are just gonna be like, oh no, it's not, but it is. And if you're running into that problem, this is gonna be the video for you. This is the video that I wish I had when I first started out, like I just said before. Fox Farm Ocean Forest is loaded with nitrogen-based amendments, which is why it's really good during the vegetative stage. But what are you gonna do if it's too hot, right? Well, of course, you're gonna give your plants a complementary secondary soil, as I like to call it, which is Happy Frog, because Happy Frog doesn't really have a lot of stuff in it. And then you got Strawberry Fields, which is loaded with phosphorus, and of course, that's what makes it a great soil during the flowering stage. Obviously, you could use something like Light Warrior as well. That's what I like to use for seedlings, or Happy Frog. I like to consider Light Warrior and Happy Frog kind of similar. So just like that, I mentioned four different soils by Fox Farm, but I mean, what are you gonna use? Now, this is the soil recipe that I like to run every single time, and it's what I've been running with the GDPs, the Skittles, and all the prior runs in 2021. Of course, I'm gonna still make the video where I show you my super soil mix I prefer, but we're gonna get into that maybe around October after our California Dream Run is over. I think that one's gonna be over like around Labor Day or something. But for now, let's just stick with Fox Farm. The reason I wanted to make this video is because a lot of you guys have been asking me what's the Fox Farm mix I've been running, and it's a question a lot of people have been asking me the last couple of months. And what I like to do is I like to make a video based on some questions and suggestions that you have. So that's how I kind of build it. Okay, so a lot of people have been asking me about this, so I think I'm gonna make a video on this now. So this is what you're gonna wanna do. You wanna take your pot, and it doesn't matter how big or small that you're running this, but this is kind of what you want to do. This is like the ratio that I like. I like to have the bottom half of the pots with nothing but straight up Strawberry Field soil mixed in with 20% perlite. And if you're asking what kind of perlite I recommend, I prefer Mother Earth size number 3. I didn't have size number 2, or size number 4 seemed like it was too big, and they didn't have size 2 available, you know, on Amazon. So I got size number 3, and I mean, my plants always loved it. I never had any drainage issue with the GDPs or the gelatos, even the run that I'm working on right now, the California Dream or the Blue Cheese. And the size of the perlite, it's more of a preference, but I used size number 3 and I love it. And the top half of the pot, I like to mix with half Ocean Forest and half Happy Frog. Just straight up 50-50 mix. Now let's talk about why I think this is the best Fox Farm soil recipe. And this is especially good if you're running autoflowers and you want to get a pretty good yield. Just think of it this way. When you transplant your young plants into their final home, the roots are going to be growing around the top half of the pot. because it hasn't gotten to the bottom yet, which is why you already know that you're gonna want something rich with nitrogen, so your leaves have that really nice lush green color. And I already know that Ocean Forest is too hot, so if you mix in that Happy Frog, which is pretty much next to nothing in it, it's gonna balance out the Ocean Forest. So now it looks like your young plants should be covered for the vegetative stage, but I mean, what about the flowering stage, right? Always remember that your roots grow quicker than you think, and by the time your plant's roots are going into the flowering stage, you're getting towards the bottom of the pot. They're gonna be using up all the flowering amendments that are in the strawberry field soil, which is why I always have the strawberry fields at the bottom. Like, that's the reason behind it. It wouldn't really make sense to have the strawberry fields at the top, since they're not going to utilize that phosphorus until later on in their stage of life. As far as adding about 20% perlite to the strawberry fields, there's a perfectly easy explanation for that, and that is because strawberry fields has absolutely trash drainage. I can't stress that enough. I ran the Skittles series. A lot of you guys saw the videos, and I mean, the drainage was so terrible. I noticed that the drainage was really good on the top, but towards the bottom, I really didn't have much runoff, so that just pretty much told me one thing, that the strawberry fields was just really bad with drainage, so I had to fix that issue. Obviously, during that run, I couldn't fix any issue because it was already done. I couldn't do anything about it. It was too late. So that's the thing about running these different mixes. You know, you work on this mix, you think you got something, and then, oh, I made a mistake here, and then you correct it on the next run. Then you correct something else on the next run. Eventually, you finally have that perfect mix, and this is what we got right here. So like I was saying, if you guys remember the Skittles run that we ran back, I think it was like around February. I think like around the spring, like maybe the end of winter, we had a root rot issue. And like I said, the issue was towards the bottom where the strawberry fields was. That's why during that GDP run, I fixed that problem, and I never had issues with my roots after that. I gave them the 20% perlite. The GDPs, I mean, they thrived. They never had any kind of root rot issue, any kind of drainage issue, or nothing like that. So that's why I tell you guys to add at least 15 or 20% of perlite to your strawberry fields. Because let me tell you something, root rot sucks. I actually tried starting out in straight up strawberry fields, and my leaves ended up getting really, really yellow, which told me that there can't be much nitrogen in that soil. But it's always been great during the flowering stage. So I was basing what I found with the experiments that I was running. And somebody in the comments section in an older video said something that Ocean Forest had more phosphorus than strawberry fields. I don't know about that, guys. You might have to look into that. I don't actually believe that. I think somebody told me the ratio was like 5, 45, 5. Pretty much that the strawberry fields didn't have nearly as much phosphorus as the Ocean Forest, but I always noticed that my flowers were a lot fatter when I was running the strawberry fields as opposed to just the Ocean Forest. So I don't know if there's any truth to that, you know. So I'm just telling you guys what I've been running. I don't know about all the NPK ratios. I never called customer service with Fox Farm, so I have no idea. You could look into that. I don't know if it was just a bad rep or whatnot, but I'm telling you guys, this is what I've been running. This is what I've had my experience with. And I know you guys are probably gonna ask me something like, is that all I'm going to need for my entire run? You also have to remember that your plants need other stuff like calcium, magnesium, pretty much your micronutrients. So you still don't want to neglect that, but at least with the soil recipe that I told you about, you're not gonna have as many issues as you would if you were running those soils separately. Because trust me, I have run those soils separately. Not good. And actually, I remember just running the Happy Frog mix. It was just Happy Frog, and oh my God, the leaves were just straight yellow. I mean, it was just like, it was just all bad. And if you're starting out, I can tell you firsthand that I know what it's like to dive into something that you don't completely understand, which is why I wanted to make this video. I'm not expecting you guys to know every single thing about every soil there is. It's just impossible unless you're doing a lot of different runs and kind of experimenting, you know. Stuff like this takes time. So hopefully this bit of information cleared up a lot of confusion as to what Fox Farm soil recipe I recommend and what I've been running. And I think by giving you guys this recipe, it's gonna eliminate a lot of the guesswork and long work that I had to do when I started growing. So I wanted to pass that information on to you. And of course, there's a lot of different soils out there and lots of different brands, but I've been running with Fox Farm for such a long time, and I just always wanted to try out all their different soils and kind of see what's gonna be the best for my plants. And you have a lot of options, but for the sake of this video, I just wanted to keep it with Fox Farm. As far as running it separately, I did run all of them separately. So the results I got pretty much was, when I was running in just Happy Frog, the seedlings were just straight yellow. There was not any green at all. They were yellowing out before it even started. And then when I was running with Ocean Forest during the seedling stage, actually, it wasn't that bad during the seedling stage. They actually thrived, but as the plants got bigger and bigger, I started noticing more nutrient burn. You know, the leaf tips were pretty much all messed up, and Ocean Forest almost has a way of tricking you. So like you think, oh, your plants are really good, and all of a sudden you're getting burned out of nowhere, and then you gotta flush, and then you're panicking, and you end up overwatering, and it just sucks, okay? So back in 2014, when I was just running Ocean Forest, it wasn't hot, and not only that, I ran nothing but Ocean Forest, and on top of that, I gave it Fox Farm nutrients, and I didn't really get that much burn at all, so that just goes to show you that their formula had to have changed somehow. Now, as far as running just the strawberry fields from start to finish, I got the yellowing that I got from Happy Frog, and that was kind of pretty much it. So the strawberry fields and the Happy Frog doesn't seem like it's got that nitrogen base that's gonna get it through the seedling and the vegetative state. That's why I was experimenting with these soils for such a long time. That's the mix that I finally got. So just as a recap, bottom of the pot, you want strawberry fields mixed in with 15 to 20% perlite, and the top half, you want Ocean Forest with Happy Frog mix. If you want it 60-40 Happy Frog or 60-40 Ocean Forest, that's pretty good, but try to keep it kind of in the middle. So I'm gonna close off today's video, but before I do, I wanna thank everyone on screen for supporting us on Patreon. I really appreciate all the love and support from you guys. All right, so I'm gonna close off today's video. Drop a fat thumbs up, drop that fat like, and subscribe for more content if you're not already subscribed, and I'll catch you guys in the next one, and as always, stay safe, peace.